unanimous, that's carried, thank you. We move on to agenda item 12, which is pages 85 to 88 in your packet.
Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is to inform members of the objection to the proposed tree preservation order and to request approval to serve the new order. An existing TPO protects some of the trees on land opposite Barnston Towers Close, but this order was served in 1972, and due to the length of time, a lot of new trees have grown, some trees have been removed, so it's becoming unclear which of these trees are now protected and removal is required. However, following consultation with the new TPO, an objection was received on the basis that the TPO plan was incorrect as it wasn't on the land registry plan. In accordance with guidance from the Department for Communities and Local Government, it's not a requirement to use the land registry plan, rather an order must include a map giving a clear indication of the position of individual trees, groups of trees or woodlands. So members are therefore requested to confirm the tree preservation order 03-78.
Okay, is there anybody want to make any comments on this?
Just very briefly, Chair, if I may, on page 85, I think item 4.1 covered it. It said the TPO plan must clearly identify the location of the trees to be protected because of the change of growth, demolition and everything else. What is there at the moment is not up to muster, if you like. So I think we're obliged to approve this, and I would certainly want to do that. Thank you.
So David has moved to approve. Do we have a second, Steve? So the recommendation is the Plan Committee confirm the key preservation order 0378 despite the objections. All those in favour? Thank you. And we move now to agenda item 13, which is on pages 89 to 92. Have a presentation, please.
Thank you, Chair. Again, the purpose of this report is to inform the committee of an objection to another tree preservation order. It's come to the authority's attention that there is a possible change in ownership of a group of trees between Talbot Court and properties on Alton Road. And these trees are in private ownership. The trees are considered to make a valuable contribution to the amenity and landscape character of the area, and the council has a duty to make provision for the preservation of trees in woodland. So the purpose of this TPO is to protect such trees, particularly where these trees are in possible danger of removal. An objection has been received on the basis that one of the trees at the rear of the garage on Talbot Road is damaging the garage. And again, all these trees are private ownership, not part of local authority land. There is an exemption under the TPO regulations which allows for the removal of trees or parts of trees where a tree is causing damage. In this instance, it's considered that the trees make valuable contributions to the landscape character, and that if there are any trees that are causing damage to the building or garage, these trees can be removed. So for these reasons, it's recommended that TPO number EM0005 is served to protect these trees.
I think we just need a little bit of clarification on this. I'm a bit ambiguous about this. If this tree is causing damage, perhaps the legal officer could advise us to what is the next course of action. Does the person whose garage allegedly is being damaged now need to serve notice on somebody to claim back the cost of the damage? But these trees apparently aren't owned by the council. No, I think we just need a bit of understanding as to where we go from here, because it seems unsatisfactory. But we can approve something which I'm happy with, but that the person who is left in a position of damaging property, it doesn't really give any indication of how we might proceed. Now, maybe that's not our job to do that, but I'm interested to know.
Thanks, Dave.
As it indicated in the previous item, there's been a question of the aggrieved resident seeking legal advice and taking appropriate action for the damage caused to his property by trees on the neighbouring property. You'd appreciate quite improper for me to give any advice on the merits.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, but there would be remedies in civil law if there's a good cause of action. Not possible for me to
just very quickly, so to be clear, it's nothing to do with the council, but these treaties apparently aren't done by the council. So it would be up to the person who's agreed to enter into civil litigation of some sort with whether or not the treaties will take a fine. So we're not involved.
Yeah.
That's fine, thank you.
Okay, Stuart.
Yeah, just on that, David might be interested to to those that belong to any council owned trees in the National Conservation Area, the Lowland Private Lands, and part of the appraisal for the conservation area, making improvements to tree coverage as a defining feature for conservation. I appreciate which trees are on the border, nevertheless, they will contribute to the DMI. And I also think it's important that Frank gets a good view of some nice green there. So I'm happy to support the recommendation and if no one else has a contribution to move that approval.
Okay, so Stuart's
moved
to approve. Do I have a second? All those in favour of the recommendation that the Planning Committee confirm the Tree Preservation Order number EN 5504/2017. Okay, that's unanimous. Thank you. Okay, so we can move on to agenda item 14, which is agenda item 14 is pages 93-120. This is planning applications decided under delegated powers, and this seeks to bring to the attention of members and ask the public to note it.
Yes, just a couple of points briefly. The first two items on page 93 cover Gilbark Hotel and the fact that we've refused planning permission for those two situations. Can I ask the officers what action will now be taken and when to enforce proceedings on the subject of these refusals?
Through you, Chair, I mean, it's a very recent decision we've made on his application, so obviously the council must then consider its stance on enforcement action and what action we're going to take. That won't progress at this stage.
Chair, so could we possibly have a report brought back to some future meeting, when appropriate, to tell us where we're up to in that? Because I'm being pestered about this by a lot of people, and now that we've actually served the notices of refusal on those two items, it would be helpful if we could progress matters further. I'm not asking for intention on it, but I'm asking if maybe have a report to the next meeting to tell us what the progress is and what you anticipate in the future to be, because a lot of people are shouting at me about this. Thank you.
If you just very quickly to say that these are only very recent refusal decisions, but we will be looking at these issues within the next week in terms of the enforcement action that we need to consider.
Thank you, Chair.
Okay, would you need a report to bring him back to committee, though, David, or would it be publicised generally?
And what we'd normally do in these circumstances is make an assessment of the enforcement that we need to take, and then normally, from an officer perspective, we just progress with that, really, through the various processes.
I think the problem is there's a great public interest in this, and I wonder whether subject to freedom of information or confidentiality, I think people who have been pursuing this problem for many years would like to see some comment from somebody as to how it's being progressed. That's all I can ask for, and I do ask for informing.
Yeah, and that's absolutely fine. I'm happy to give that to you once we come to a decision in terms of what action we need to take. I understand the public interest point around that, David.
And
happy to keep members informed.
Thank you, David. Actually, David, I'm very pleased to hear that you've been able to take important action very quickly on the basis that my understanding is that after the last 15 years, the structures have been in place for 10 years without planning permission.
So I hope we've demonstrated, obviously, that the refusal of these two applications, considering these matters next week and then taking action that we consider to be appropriate, I think is a fairly swift response to these matters.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Could somebody invite Steve back in? No.
I'll never forgive you, Chair. I'm in danger of having to watch Everton.
Okay, so we're noting agenda item 14. So moving on to agenda item 15. This is planning appeals decided between the 1st of July and the 30th of September on pages 121 to 124. Are we happy to know those?
Excuse me, Chair. I was just on 123, the last one. It says partly allowed, it was refused. Council decision was to refuse it, but the appeals decision was partly allowed, not just a bit of
Chair. The inspector made a decision. There were two elements to the scheme. There was a carport and a veranda, and the inspector decided that because they were so separate, they were severable, because of the way used, so that he could make a decision on one and not the other. So he allowed one and refused the other, which is quite unusual.
Do we know which?
Yeah, the veranda was allowed, and the carport was dismissed.
Oh my God.
Just on that, when the question's been asked, I have got a question. Do we enjoy all those awesome powers to partially agree with? Is that what's there to regard as instant pleasure? The second point that I'd just like to ask in terms of the appeals that we've lost, I think often the test really of looking at these is whether or not the inspector has received and granted an application for costs, and that's the judgment that then the inspector makes about whether we've been reasonable or unreasonable. It might be useful in future, I think, if as part of that, we could also know, maybe like as an addition to the template, whether the second application for costs was allowed or turned down. I took the opportunity to look at one of them, and the application for costs was in fact refused, which really, to me, says the inspector, yes, has looked at the application and has chosen to disagree with us, but hasn't necessarily, you know, demurred from the fact that we have the right to tear it down and have not acted unreasonably in that respect. Is that a fair comment? And is that a possible addition we can have to allow?
Okay, that's a good point. I'll
take
it would be nice if you could choose, but unfortunately that's not a lot of us. Okay, so we've moved on to agenda item 16. Now this actually should need a Thornton Manor Hotel update on the Thornton Hall, and David is just going to give us a brief further update on this. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. This is very brief indeed, because as you will recall from the last update, again, we're in the hands of the court, really, of the procedures that are going ahead at the moment. So what the court have advised the council is that the date for the hearing on this application will be set for as soon as possible after the 10th of November, and that we'll just keep members advised of that legal process as it develops. Yeah, nothing further to say on that.
Okay.
We're just in the court processes.
Thank you very much, David. I haven't been made aware of any other urgent business, so I'm now declaring this in place. Thank you.